Hi, today I've got a really great solo for you. It's the solo from Touch of Grey off the Grateful Dead's 1987 In the Dark album. Alright, so quick note about the form. The song starts off with an introduction, then it has a verse, it has a chorus, and it has a bridge. So Jerry's solo is over the chords to the verse and the chorus. So I'm going to quickly go over those chords. I'm not going to go into much detail because the chords of the song will be a completely different lesson. So here we go with the verse. So then that's repeated, and then we have the chords to the chorus, which goes like this. So now let's take a look at the solo. So a quick note about the solo. As I mentioned before, Jerry was really fond of playing out of chord shapes. So if his style of playing is something you're really into, I would really recommend learning the cage system and all the shapes that go along with that. An in-depth explanation of the cage system and different scale shapes will be left to another lesson. All right, let's get started. The solo begins with this phrase. So we're playing over a B chord, and then it goes to F sharp and back to B. So of course he's playing out of this B shape right here. It's the caged C shape, starting with the pinky up on the 14th fret of the fifth string. And right out of there, we have this B arpeggio. So the actual phrase Jerry's playing, it's limited more to the fourth, third, and second string set. So we have just playing up and down that arpeggio. And then for the F sharp chord, we're going to play out of this F sharp shape, which would be a G cage shape, and we can just bar with our first finger here on the 11th fret, and we'll play, and then we'll go back to that 12th fret of the second string, which is a B, and that's the root of the B chord that it goes back to. So over those two chords, the B to the F sharp to the B, we have. This is a good time to point out that in Jerry's playing and in this solo specifically, not all notes are created equal. And what I mean by that is that he doesn't play them all at the same volume. He accents certain notes, and that really makes his style. So if, as you can hear in this first phrase, instead of going, we have, so mastering that will really give you Jerry sound. Then next we're playing over an E to an A to an E chord, and we're going to play this phrase. I think it's very necessary that you really start on this note. You can just slide up out of anywhere, but I am starting on a G sharp, which is the third of a G chord, of an E chord, and I'm sliding up to the 11th fret of the fourth string, and then we're going to play out of this. It's the G shape of an E chord. So we're going to play, it's the G cage shape of the E chord, and we're going to play. So note, when we move to the A chord, we're playing 10th fret of the second string, which is an A note, works perfectly over the A chord. And then we pull off to the 9th fret of the second string, G sharp, which is the 3rd of the E chord. So again, I've mentioned this before, you could play these solos without any accompaniment and you would hear the chord changes, because Jerry was a master of really making the chord sound, playing the changes. Alright, now we're going up to an F sharp chord. So Jerry shifts that G cage shape of the E chord up 2 frets, or a whole step. So now you're barring on the 11th fret, you're in that F sharp shape. So over that we have. So let me play up to this point from the beginning, and then I'll explain that last phrase. All right, so when we shift up to that F sharp, we're playing. So again, out of that G shape of the F sharp chord. Then we hammer on to the 13th fret. Then 11 to the 2nd string, 11 to the 3rd string. Then we have 12, 14 of the 2nd string. Then we land on the 11th fret of the 1st string, which we're in that B shape again, and we're landing on the D sharp, or the 3rd of the B chord. And now moving right along, we have this great phrase. So playing out of the E shape, the E cage shape of an E chord, we're going to start on the G and slide up to the G sharp, the 3rd of E, and play the 12th fret of the 1st string. That interval is known as a 6th, and you'll find that Jerry's playing a lot. Then we slide down to the 11th fret and back up to the 12th. Then we do this cool little pull-off lick where we pull off from the 14th to the 12th fret and then slide down to the 11th. Then we go back to the 12th fret of the 1st string, then the 11th fret of the 1st string, pull off from the 14th to the 12th fret of the 2nd string, back to the 14th fret, and then the 11th fret of the 1st string. And now we're on that D sharp for our B chord. Alright, so that was that set of first chord changes right before we repeat it. So I'm going to play everything we have so far. So now we're over the B to the F sharp to the B chord part again. So for that we have. So we're playing out of this C shape of the B chord to the G shape of the F chord. And we have the 11th fret of the 1st string, followed by 14 to 12 on the 2nd. Then the 11th fret of the 1st string, and 14th fret of the 2nd string. And now playing out of that F sharp shape, we have 11th fret of the 2nd to 3rd string, then back to the 2nd string, then 14, 12 on the second string. Then we have this. So again, we're playing out of that G chord shape of the E chord. We're sliding that shape down two frets, one whole step. And we have 13 sliding down to the 11th of the 4th string, pulling off to the 9th fret, then 9th fret of the 2nd string, 9th fret of the 3rd string, then 9th fret of the 3rd string, 9th fret of the 2nd string, back to 9th fret of the 3rd string. Now to play over the A chord, we're going to play that A, the root of the A chord, 10th fret of the 2nd string. Play it twice, followed by the 12th fret of the 2nd string, followed by the 9th fret, and we land on that G sharp over the E chord. So that part is... So now to play over an F sharp chord, we're going to take that same G shape of the E chord, slide it up two frets or one whole step to be in the F sharp. All right, and it looks like this. All right, so on the 11th fret, we have the 11th fret of the 4th, 3rd, 2nd string, then back to the 3rd string. Then we have a B triad descending, starting on the 14th fret of the 1st string, 11th fret of the 1st string, 12th fret of the 2nd string, 11th fret of the 3rd string. Then we have 14, 11, 12, 14 on the 2nd string, and then the 11th fret of the 1st string, and that lands on that D sharp over our B chord. Then we're going to play a series of 6th intervals over our E chord. So that's 12 sliding up to 13 on the 3rd string, 12th fret of the 1st string. Then we're going to start where we left off in that 13th fret of the 4th string, slide it up to the 14th fret, then play the 14th fret of the 1st string. Start on that 14th fret of the 3rd string, slide it up 2 frets to the 16th fret, play the 16th fret of the 1st string, then repeat. Now that brings us to the chorus chords, starting on an F sharp. So we have this phrase. So over the F sharp, we're playing out of that G shape again. We have our bar right here on the 11th fret, and we play the 11th fret of the 3rd string, 2nd string, back to 3rd string, back to 2nd string, then 12, 14 in the 2nd string. Then over the B chord, we're going to pull off from the 12 to the 11th fret of the 2nd string, back to the 12, 14, then 11th fret of the 1st string, landing on that D sharp, or the 3rd of the B chord. So we have... We're going to play the 12th fret of the 1st string and E over our E chord. Then we have this nice little lick. So that's 12, 11 of the 1st string, 14, 12, 11 of the 2nd string. So we play a variation of that first lick, This time it's... So this next lick goes like this. So that's 11th fret of the 3rd and 2nd string, then 12th fret, then we repeat that, then 11, 12, 14 on the 2nd string, and 11th fret of the 1st string. Then we play the 13th fret of the 3rd string, followed by the 12th fret of the 1st string. And then we have this kind of... So those two notes, I play the 13th fret of the 3rd string and the 14th fret of the 1st string. They're kind of... They're almost inaudible. You can hear them just a little bit. And then we do that 12, 11 of the 1st string, 14, 12... And then it's kind of just a muted note instead of the 11th fret. And then we play the 11th fret of the 2nd string. So we have... ...11, 12, 14 on the 2nd string. Pull off 12, 11, back to 12, and then 14 on the 2nd string. And the 11th fret of the 1st string. And now the ending chords of the chorus are an A, E, F sharp. And then we kind of have that chord progression from the intro, the... which kind of serves as an interlude between the chorus and the verse, even though it is a part of the chorus chords. So over all those chords I just mentioned, the A to the E to the F sharp, we're playing a series of arpeggios that sound like this. So over the A chord, we're playing an A arpeggio, or part of it. We have the 14th frets of the 3rd and 2nd string. So that's the root and the 3rd of the A chord. Then over the E chord, we're playing 12, 9 on the 2nd string, then the 9th fret of the 3rd string. So we have the 5th, 3rd, and root of the E chord. Then over the F sharp, we're playing out of this G shape of the cage shape again. So we're playing, it's an F sharp arpeggio. It's going to be the 3rd, the root, and the 5th of an F sharp. So 11 of the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th string. Then 11 of the 2nd string, hammering onto the 12th fret. Then 11th fret of the 2nd string. Then 13, 11 on the 2nd string, and then 9 on the 3rd string. And now we're playing over an E chord, and that's an E, the root of E. So from the E, A to E chords, we're going to play 9th fret of the 3rd string, then 9th frets of the 2nd to 3rd string. So that's the root and the 3rd of an E chord. Out of that arpeggio, we have... Then we're playing the 10th fret of the 2nd string in A, the root of our A chord. Pulling off to the 9th fret, that G sharp. and we're sliding into our bar chord shape on the 11th frets of the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings for our F sharp. So that's 9th to the 11th fret on the 4th string, then 11 on the 3rd and 2nd string, then back to the 11th fret of the 3rd string, then the 11th fret of the 3rd, 2nd, 3rd string, then we played the 12th fret of the 2nd string, that's our B, our root note of our B chord we're now on, to the 11th fret, which is the 5th, then back to the B, and then pull off to the 11th fret of the 2nd string, which is the 3rd of our F sharp chord. So from the arpeggios, the A, E, F sharp, we have... play the whole thing slowly with me.